Thanks, Scott. Like a lot of you, I get to spend most of my days with exceptional young people. These are the 19 that I work with on a daily basis, and they're exceptional in themselves, but they're also exceptional in what they're trying to do. They certainly inspire me every day, as your athletes inspire you. They also challenge me a lot every day. They challenge me to be a better coach. So I wake up in the morning, my first thoughts are the team. How can I be a better coach for the team? And you probably feel that way too. When you start to think about training and you come to a conference like this, it's important to think, who are you training? Who are your athletes? The athletes that were in the first slide are likely to be quite different than the athletes you're working with. Luckily, we have a long history, and Coach Vigil knows all of it, an observation that shows the best methods of training from anybody around the world. Because the best distance runners in the world have come from different places throughout history. It's never been, for very long periods of time, the same group from the same country that have been the best. If you think back to the Finnish runners, they were the best. Then Great Britain was the best. Now East Africans are the best. Who knows who's going to be the best? We don't know. Maybe there are other people. Some people will say you need to look at the background of the athlete you're working with. What's their sort of ancestry, if you will? In Team USA Arizona, most of our athletes, probably like most of yours, are from Western European descent. We have one athlete of East African descent. I think that's less important than this concept, which is the training age of your athlete. The training age of your athlete. So most U.S. athletes don't start training until they get to the high school coaches that are in here. That's what they do. As Coach Vigil talks about, as a result, we have to catch up aerobically. Because some of these guys, this is what they start doing at age 5 or 6. This is the trip to school. It looks a lot different than what I see in my neighborhood. This is a little bit more the type of athlete that we begin to work with. Is there any surprise, should it be any surprise, that these will be good at distance running? Of course not. They should be. They're training from a very early age. What's interesting and most hopeful is how surprising it is we can get these guys up to speed. How quickly we can catch up aerobically if we apply the principles that we've learned from the best. So by the time the athletes get to our team, Team USA Arizona, their training age is 6 to 9 years. They started in high school at some time and usually went through 4 or 5 years of college. So that gives me 3 to 5 years for them to catch up aerobically to match the peak years that our athletes see in distance running, which is sort of 28 to 35. Does that make sense? Now these guys can be really good in their early 20s, right? Because they got 15 years of training under their belt already. I've got to get, the time is later for us to get our athletes to be their best. Now would it be better if we started doing this? Of course. But I don't think it's going to happen. I think we're going to be there for a little while, but it's okay. I know we pound on it a lot, but it's okay to get these athletes. We can change them with smart training.